Welcome back, detectives. For today's reading lesson, you are thinking all about how mystery books usually go, what you know about mystery books, and the things that are normally found in mystery books, just like we talked about in our mini lesson earlier this week. So as you're reading today, you are going to check off in this table to the right all of the things that you are seeing in your mystery book that most mystery books tend to have. So, does yours have a mystery? Does it have a detective? Are there co-detectives or sidekicks that help? Are there suspects? Do some of the suspects have motives or reasons why they'd commit the crime? Is there a witness, someone who maybe saw some or part of it happen? And is there a solution in the end? So, some of these things your book may not have, because remember, not all mystery books have every single one of these things. And you also might not be at the end of your mystery book yet to know if there's a solution yet. So only check it off if it's things that you have seen so far in your mystery book. And then after, use about 2 to 3 sentences to tell us how does thinking about the things that most mystery books usually have, how does that help you when you're reading? How does that help you as a mystery reader to think, how do these books usually go? Does that help you as a detective to solve the mystery when you think about what mystery books are usually like? And how does that help you? So in about 2 to 3 sentences, you're going to explain to us why thinking of all these things up in this table here, how that helps you as a reader. So remember, you are reading for 25 minutes today in a mystery book, which you have the mystery library right here and that timer. So read for your 25 minutes first. And as you're reading, if you want to check off the things that you see as you go, that's great. And if there's any other things that you notice that your mystery book has that we didn't talk about in the chart, feel free to add that in the text box below as well, or create a new text box to let us know what else your mystery book has that was not listed in that chart. So have fun being a mystery reader today. Really think about how mystery books usually go and what you usually find in them. Happy reading.